Check this Mustang out, guys. This is cool one here. It's like an Eleanor clone from the movie Gone in 60 Seconds. It's got a couple big differences. One being that it is a Roush Supercharged Coyote, which is, you know, definitely cool. Definitely an upgrade from the, I think the car in the movie would have been displayed as like a 427 kind of deal. Definitely well done piece. It is an automatic, which would have been cool if it was a stick, but to each their own. Can't see the glare, but obviously very, very well done car. Very nice. There's only like 400 miles on it. They have been doing some driving stuff with it, but we'll go around the other side here in a second and show it to you. But yeah, it's a 4R70W transmission controlled with the trans is controlled with an atomic MSC atomic EFI controller, which I don't really know much about. It has a dyno mode, so I had it in dyno mode. It's mostly in here for some drivability stuff, and I'm gonna go through all the full throttle kind of deal. But it is a cool looking car. I love this movie, the movie growing up, Gone in 60 Seconds there, so super cool to see something like this. Again, it's only got 400 miles on it. It's like it's brand new, but yeah, definitely cool. Can't wait to get in this thing and see what it makes. Just pump gas, low boost number stuff. I don't expect it to make anything crazy. We're gonna be doing all the tuning with the converter unlocked. But I'm gonna dive into this and see what we can make with it. One more shot of the engine bay here just because it's cool. Alright, all wrapped up with it. You can see by the flare and the torque curve there that the converter was unlocked. I only turned to the 7100. It made 501 to the tire, which is probably going to seem pretty low to most of you supercharged Coyote guys. But keep in mind that the converter being unlocked is relatively significant. It is a 4R70 as opposed to like a 6R80 with the converter locked or unlocked. I don't know how efficient this trans is. But it's only making like 9 pounds of boost, pump gas, super conservative tune. This thing's just a daily driver, you know, go get ice cream in it kind of thing. But yeah, I don't think it's a bad number, really. Keep in mind, in my personal car, the locked transmission 6R80 to an unlocked turbo 400 with a PTC 16.0 converter. Now, totally not the same thing, because we don't know what converter's in this, but that lock to unlock conversion was worth 150 horsepower at the tire on the same boost level. Based on injector duty, this thing's got a set of 52s flowed at 43.5 PSI, and it's got 58 pounds of base fuel pressure instead of the 43.5. So that injector is about a 60 pound injector at that fuel pressure. And we were 89% injector duty at 7,100, which calculates to mid 700 flywheel mark. So the drivetrain loss is definitely significant, which isn't uncommon with a, you know, looser aftermarket converter. It is flaring to about 5,100 when you stand on it. So you would call that a 5,000 or so converter. So it's not definitely not a dyno queen, not going after a number here anyway, like I said, but just so you guys kind of get a grasp of why that's a little low if you're used to the blown Coyote world, right? But nonetheless, man, gonna be a great cruiser. This thing's just cool. I kind of want to just drive it around. Too bad it's like 30 degrees outside here in Michigan, but yeah, that's it for this one. I'm gonna get it off of here and move on to the next project.